Hi, my friends. I'm Luca Turilli of Turilli Lione Rhapsody, and you are watching Loud TV. See you soon, my friends. No, but in my case, I cannot speak for Fabio, of course. No, he has his own thing, you should ask him. But in my case, it was very, very easy because there was this long saga on which all the albums, the first 10 albums were based. So we knew that after the album number 10, let's say the saga would have ended. And so that was the right moment for me to leave the band because then, you know, I wanted to do other things, especially when I'm basically a composer. Me, I'm not a live musician, no? So I'm a composer, so I like to compose different things. I cannot, after 10 years or 15 years, even more, no, think to do the same thing. So this is very essential for me to satisfy my heart and soul also. And I think for an artist, that's the priority, no? Before the money, before the business, all that. So in some way for me, this was the basic reason. So it was a kind of friendly split at the time, in the sense that I realized that I wanted to do other things. After the end of the saga, there was my ex-colleague Alex that wanted to do other things or going on or in a different ways. I don't know really, but then it happened what it happened, yes. So before even being a live musician, because I prefer really, my great ambient is the studio situation. So I feel really good when I'm there in front of my computers, composing with all the instruments available in front of me. That's my, what I love to do.
So you have never think about stop music? Impossible for you?
No. I was thinking to change style of music because now my favorite band is Muse. I love Adele. For me, is the best singer existing, best voice. So I wanted just to take a break from what I was doing because of what I told you before. No, because I feel the need to experiment different things. So I wanted to make something in that style. So let's say more symphonic rock, I would say. And yes, I wanted to take a break. I wanted also to dedicate myself to the piano more than to the guitar, to make maybe some projects. In, you know, it's called emotional piano. So kind of project where I play the piano with acoustic instruments, things like that. Very heart and soul based projects. So things like that. So that was the basic plan. But then there was also, after we saw that the tour went so great with Fabio, this farewell tour that followed, where we wanted, and for me that was great to make that tour because it was kind of final celebration, a moment, a tour where we would have played for a last time some important songs we played in our career. So it was a very important moment for me, really to close the chapter in some way, no, in a very important way. And the fans were happy, all that, we were happy because in the beginning we planned the farewell tour would have been related to some festivals only. A few festivals, so, but in the end the result was so great and people really wanted us all over the world that after we are speaking now about 2 years of farewell tour, so imagine. And then we wanted really to close the chapter in that moment, so that was the time when I said, okay, I make this farewell tour and then I stop with metal, for I take a break and I make something else. And that was the plan of Fabio too. At the time we said, but you know what, now it's great, it was great this tour together, 2 years, So it was so great, the collaboration. Everybody wanted to hear something made by me and Fabio together, that we were thinking at the time as first thing, as I wanted, as I told you, to do different things. We thought, well, we can make a rock project in the Queen style, because Queen is one of our favorite bands for both of us. And so we thought, why not, no? And I find Fabio's voice absolutely excellent for this kind of special project, I would say, no? And Queen is a special band, so with all these vocal parts, vocal interlude, and so that, and so we thought to do something like that. But then there was the, you know, when something goes very well, the promoters, the management, record company, are really interested, no? So they go on asking you, no, you should really go on, things like that, especially in this kind of market nowadays, no? So in the end, we received so many proposals, and to still going on in the metal. So we thought, okay, yes, but not as a Rhapsody, of course. No, we wanted to make something different. And so we said, okay, you know what? We can do a band, but really playing the music we like to play nowadays. So we decided, okay, we go on, you know, we find this name, Zero Gravity. We go on creating this new band, and we want heavy guitars. We want really the sound of the modern production. So if I do something new in metal, I want really to make something sounding powerful, like the music we like to listen nowadays in the metal, no? So I like bands like Dream Theater, Within Temptation, Rammstein, even something, no? So we wanted to make something special also if we went on with metal. And so came the idea of Zero Gravity. We proposed this, the plan, to our management, to the promoters, and we understood immediately that it would have been impossible to use the name Zero Gravity, because of the same reason I told you before, the fact of the market, the bad situation of the market, would have simply not allowed to have enough good offers to start an adventure in this sense with another name. And so we understood soon that the only chance for us to go on being a metal band would have been to keep the name Rhapsody. In that case, we could have had some good offers to be able to start a new adventure. And so we decided, okay, if we have really to go on as Rhapsody, first thing, we change the logo. So really to show to the people that we want to make something, let's say, we can take, let's say, the symphonic, cinematic impact of Rhapsody, but really move in a different direction. And that was the perfect compromise. So we decided to call the album Zero Gravity, and to use, to create this motto that is very important for us, as became also the undertitle of our new album, of our debut album, and is Rebirth and Evolution. So this is really to make understand clearly to the people that yes, we will take the trademark of Rhapsody, symphonic cinematic impact, but really we will move, we will evolve it into something different, respecting what we like to play, to compose nowadays. Yes, absolutely, because for us it was very important to have an artwork, let's say, I don't want to say, because it's not, this album is not about science fiction, I want to be precise, no? This is modern, it's a modern album, next album can be a completely different cover, and this is the freedom we like, artistically speaking, to have, me and Fabio, for this new band. So we could use, doesn't matter which new instrument we want to use, we can use whatever artwork we can use, we want to use. And in this case, the artwork represents a kind of metaphoric message, no? So we have this technological modern town representing the material aspect of life, and we have this phoenix rising and in some way trying to reach a higher level of consciousness. So we have the spiritual versus the material aspect of life, and everything in this album is about this conceptually speaking, for image, lyrics, music, and all that, no? We always spoke about that. I think every artist, even if he speaks about one girl he loves, or he left him, whatever, leaved him, in some way he's speaking about the spiritual aspect of life, no? Because love, all that related topics is always about spiritual. You can speak in a more superficial way, in a more deep way, using a fantasy saga to filter it. But in the end, artistically speaking, we always speak about the same thing. And this is the mystery of existence, the mystery of life, no? And so, of course, like in our case, with Rhapsody, Rhapsody of Fire, we spoke about all this in filtering all these topics with a saga, heroic fantasy saga, no? But already at that time, if you think the Emerald Sword was related, I called it Emerald, when I created the concept, because it was related to the emerald tablet of Hermes Trismegistus. So already at the time there was the as above, so below concept, no? The relation between material and spiritual aspects of life. And now we do the same, but in a more direct way with this new band. So we speak also about, we have a song about Leonardo da Vinci, we have different songs about different topics, but they all speak about the same thing in some way. But you know, we wanted, Fabio and I wanted, immediately decided we want to enrich this album, especially because it was the debut album of this new band, with having some additional variety, and this variety could have been offered by new singer, by different voices, no? Especially finding good combination between the singers and the voice of Fabio. And I think we made a great choice, because thanks to Fabio we could think to have Elise, because they collaborated together since for many months in the past, no? She was the chorist of Camelot in the moment Fabio was the singer. So, I mean, there was a kind of professional relation already established. So it was easy in some way to get Elise, but of course we didn't know if she would have liked the song or not, you know? But as DNA, I think it was really a great song in the style she could have liked, so very modern, sounding very close to what she's doing. We had a great great expectation and a great answer from Elise, that really loved the song. So we have now this song with this great combination between Elise and Fabio that we really love, at the point that probably will be one of our next single, no, this song. Yes, because the record company, of course, loves the result and all that. So we are very, very happy. And then we have the song I Am, a little bit more progressive, more Queen style, because of course, as I told you before, we wanted to make this Queen project, but from the moment we decide to go on with in the metal and with this new band, we of course, we brought some Queen elements, speaking about the vocal parts, also in this band, no? And I think this will be one of the features, one of the characteristics of the new band. No? Every time we will have something a little bit in that style, because this is allowed by the great voice of Fabio in some way. And then, so we had on this song I Am also the presence of this Italian singer, Mark Basile, that is the singer of the Italian band DGM, that personally, and I make a mea culpa, I didn't know. So I knew, I discovered, thanks to the work with Simone, no? As Simone was the engineer for this album, the guy responsible for the mix of the master of the album. Then of course I discovered his band, and when I discovered the voice of Mark that Fabio knew already, we decided immediately, yes, it would be great to have him performing in this song too. Also because his voice fit very well with this kind of progressive ambience in some way, because I think we have a few songs apart from the Queen influence. You can also notice some Dream Theater influences, all that. And I always loved in Dream Theater. I'm not a fan of the technique, you know, the ultra technique also, because I don't care of the technique in some way, no? You see also me as guitar player and keyboard player, being a keyboard player and guitar player, I like to be enough good to play what I like to hear. That's enough. I don't need to, but I like still the modern elegance of Dream Theater, no? The seriousness. And this is what we want really to have in this band.
Engine running.